As we learn to use z-scores, we will need to be able to interpret the z-table. Different statistics books present z-tables in different ways. Some include every possible z-score above or below the mean in tables that stretch across multiple pages. The z-table that I have provided for you fits onto a single page. This is the Swiss Army knife of z-tables. It gives you everything you need in a compact package. Right now, you are seeing only the first column of the z-table so that I can teach you how to use it. The important thing to remember is that the values in this z-table tell the proportions of the scores between the mean and a given z-score. Let's look for the proportion of scores between the mean and a z of a positive 1.0. So look down this first column until you see the z-score of 1.0. The proportion that you find there is 0.3413. See how that works? Let's try some other examples. What is the proportion of scores between the mean and a z of 0.2? It is 0.0793. What is the proportion of scores between the mean and a z of 0.8? 0.2881. What is the proportion of scores between the mean and a z of 1.2? 0.3849. You may notice that I left off the positive or negative sign for these z-scores. I want you to understand that the proportion of scores between the mean and a z of positive 1.2 is exactly the same proportion as between the mean and negative 1.2. You may also notice that the z-scores only go to one decimal point. What if you want to find z-scores that go to two decimal points? For that, we need the rest of the table. You find the z-score for the first decimal point in the blue column on the left, labeled z. Then you find your second decimal point along the columns at the top of the table. So let's practice. What is the proportion of scores between the mean and z of 0.25? We start with the z-score for 0.2. Then we move right to the column labeled 0.05. The value that we find, 0.0987. So what is the proportion of scores between the mean and a z of 0.82? As before, we start with the 0.8, then move to the column labeled 0.02. The value, 0.2939. Let's try some other examples. What is the proportion of scores between the mean and a z of 1.23? 0.3907. The proportion of the scores between the mean and a z of 1.18, 0.3810. What is the proportion of the scores between the mean and a z of 0.76, 0.2764. Now, of course, the entire table does not fit on this slide. The table that you have in your notes is much more extensive, but the rest of the table works the same way that I've shown you here. Now that you know how to use the Z table, let's apply what we know. Use the Z table to find the proportion of scores between the mean and the following Z scores. I will ask the question, then give you the correct answer. Feel free to pause the video at any point as you work out the answer on your own. For a z of positive 1.00, the proportion between the mean and that z is 0.3413. For z equals positive 2.00, 0.4772. for z equals positive 3.00, 0.4987. For z equals 0.11, 0.0438. For a z of 0.75, 2734. For z equals 1.25, 0.3944. For z equals 1.58, 0.4429. And for z equals 2.64, 0.4959. Now that you have these basics, it's time to learn to find proportions under the normal curve.